What if I told you that prehistoric otters weren't anything like the ones we see at the zoo today? Prehistoric otters, or the Enhydriodon Omoensis, was a lion-sized, almost bear-like mammal that roamed Earth 3 million years ago. And what if I told you that our early ancestor, the early seeds of mankind, walked alongside the Enhydriodon Omoensis? As if that wasn't essential enough, what if I told you that the two species may have competed for food and resources? According to a study published in September 2022 in the French scientific journal Compétence Rendus Pelvol, scientists have discovered a new, distant, ancient relative of modern-day otters. Enhydriodon was a genus of otters that lived during the Miocene and Pliocene epochs, approximately 6 and 2 million years ago. In relative terms, most otters were large compared to their modern, adorable relatives during this time. Omoensis fossils were discovered in the southwest area of Lower Omo Valley, Ethiopia, its location of discovery inspired. Most species of giant otters are thought to have heavily populated Eurasia and Africa during the Miocene epoch. A research team led by Camille Grohe of the University of Poitiers has been intensely studying the fossils left behind by the Omoensis, specifically its femur and teeth. Despite the remains being fragmentary, the team determined the otter's monstrous size based on these two components alone. Modern otters range anywhere from 4 pounds to 100 pounds, which is comparable to a household dog. But the Enhydriodon Omoensis is estimated to have been much, much bigger, perhaps even closer to the size of a lion. Giant otters of smaller proportions are known to have roamed Eurasia and Africa, but Enhydriodon Omoensis is the largest discovered species thus far. Researchers estimate Omoensis to have weighed in at 200 kilograms or 440 pounds on average. To put the size of Enhydriodon Omoensis into context, we have to look at otters in the modern world. Current species of otters can greatly vary in size and shape. The largest otters of today's world are the giant South American otter, Terranora brasiliensis, and the northern sea otter, Enhydra lutris canyoni. According to the Alaska Department of Fish and Game, the northern sea otter can grow upwards of 5 feet in length, but can weigh over 100 pounds. The study's co-author and geochemist, Kevin Uno, believes to have discovered the most peculiar characteristic of the otter, something other than its enormous size. Modern otters are fully amphibious mammals, similar to hippos, but have carnivorous diets, meaning they only eat meat. Otters usually prefer to snack on mostly aquatic organisms such as fish, frogs, turtles, and crabs. Kevin Uno proposes a theory based on the isotopes in the Enhydriodon Omoensis teeth, in which the enormous otter was not as amphibious as its present-day counterparts. The Omoensis differed from contemporary relatives in the sense that they hunted terrestrial animals and not aquatic. Traditionally, Enhydriodon otters are considered to be amphibious, meaning they were suited to hunt, live, and breed in land or water environments. They would have had hunted mollusks, turtles, catfish, and smaller crocodiles, animals common in African freshwater. This theory was tested by Dr. Uno and his colleagues. The team analyzed stable isotopes of oxygen and carbon found in the tooth enamel left by Enhydriodon Omoensis. Isotopes are variations of an element, in this case oxygen and carbon, with different numbers of neutrons. They expected to find values in the fossil to be closer to those of hippos or other semi-aquatic animals. However, Enhydriodon Omoensis had values relating to terrestrial mammals more so than semi-aquatic. Even more so, the values were similar to big cats and hyenas from the Omo Valley fossil deposits. Something even more surprising to the research team is the theory that Enhydriodon Omoensis diet was largely composed of vegetation, grasses, and trees, making this otter more of a herbivore than a carnivore. Though, other scientists on the team disagreed with this analysis, citing that it was more likely for Enhydriodon Omoensis to be an omnivore, eating both meat and vegetation. Living in prehistoric Africa, Enhydriodon Omoensis had plenty of sources for food, until the Pliocene transition. During this time, Earth was changing drastically from climate to geographical. The Omo Valley was becoming drier and less fruitful. Vast changes to an animal environment can be challenging, even driving the species to extinction. Researchers believe that the Enhydriodon Omoensis could have adapted and lived longer if it wasn't for one thing. Early hominins, prehistoric humans, lived amongst these beasts and walked the valley alongside them. Our much smaller ancestors, the Australopithecines, moved into the otter's natural habitat, likely looking for better food or water sources. While the Australopithecines were considerably smaller than Enhydriodon Omoensis, the otter may not have had the ability to compete with the bipedal hunters. The extinction event that caused Enhydriodon Omoensis to fade out could be linked to the many geological, climate, and biotic changes that were happening during the Eastern African Rift. The major change that researchers believed tipped the scales negatively was the incursion of early hominins into the carnivore guild. For now, Dr. Uno, Camille Grohe, and other research teams plan to continue studying the giant otter fossils in hopes of uncovering their secrets. Enhydriodon Omoensis will continue to belong in the genus until something changes. A slew of Enhydriodon fossils have already been found in Eastern Africa, where Enhydriodon Omoensis was found, and other locations. The research team responsible for Enhydriodon Omoensis discovery plan to expand their search by examining other African fossils, studying tooth enamel, and the configuration of their bones, all with the hope of bettering our understanding of how prehistoric otters once lived millions of years ago. What's your favorite large extinct animal? Let me know in the comments which extinct mammal I should cover next. If you learned something new today, please help support by liking this video and subscribing.